أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
تبلوا بالقليل من القليل، تبلوا بالقليل من القليل، وهي الزاد للسفر الطويل.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Allah the Exalted, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us our sins and to pardon us for our shortcomings. Verily, whomever Allah guides to Islam, no one can lead astray. And whomever Allah allows to go astray because they do not want any guidance, then no one can guide. And I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. May Allah exalt his mention. May Allah grant him peace, his companions, his wives, and all those who follow them on their righteous path until the day of judgment. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the creation, and particularly the children of Adam, with the tendency to sin. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith in Tirmidhi, "Kullu ibn Adam khata," and I will translate it by the meaning, not by the word. Every son of Adam has a tendency to sin. Not born a sinner, has a tendency to sin. And this is actually part of the test that me and you are supposed to go through in this life. The fact that Allah allowed us to be in this fashion is in order for the testing to manifest. The same way when you go to school, you could be lazy, you could not do the work, but you want to pass, so you do the work and you strive for you to be tested, so you will either pass or fail. And similarly, and more great in this sense, is our life. Our life, each one of us, his own life. It is a test. And although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us with the tendency to sin, Allah in his omniscience, his ultimate knowledge, he knew that we were weak and that we will disobey. Yet he sent revelation through messengers, and he informed us that there are some limitations which we are not supposed to violate. There are limitations that Allah has laid down in our lives that we are not supposed to violate, but because of our weakness we will violate. Now this may seem like a paradox, something confusing. It is not, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made an outlet. He gave us a solution, very practical. It is based on strong determination to abandon the violation of these limitations and to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As simple as it sounds, this is the only solution that is found, the only practical solution available for humanity, and it is only available in Islam. And just to give you an example, Christianity, the religion with probably the largest adherence in the world. Some say Islam is overpopulated the universe with more Muslims, Allahu A'lam. But let's say a big religion with many adherents have a very different concept. They believe that God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, created Adam and Eve, who sinned, right? Now, after they sinned, they had what they call the original sin, the sin that each human being inherited afterwards. According to them, Allah was unable to forgive Adam and Eve. And of course they blame Eve. They blame Eve being the woman, she's the reason behind the destruction of everything. So much so that at some points in time, they used to have gatherings in church to discuss whether a woman had a soul or not. Does a woman have a soul? Because they said she can't. She's the reason for the destruction. She's the one who seduced Adam to eat from the tree, and all the problems we have is because of that. Of course, this is not the case. But anyways, they believe that this is the case, and that everybody inherited that sin. And that sin continued to multiply, and multiply, and multiply. And God is unable to forgive. So much so, that it says in Genesis, this is one of the books in the Bible, in the Old Testament, it says in Genesis chapter 6, verse 6, and the Lord was sorry that He created man on earth, and it grieved him to his heart. Listen to this. God, He felt sorry, He regrets that He made the wrong move by creating Adam, and he had all these problems, all these sins, and it grieved him to his heart. So they say the sin continued to multiply, that it required divine sacrifice. That some blood, must be shed, but it cannot be the blood of anyone, it must be the blood of God Himself. So they say that God became incarnate in Jesus, the Son of Mary, who is also the Son of God, and then He allowed Himself to get killed in order to please Himself, for the people to be free of their sin. This is what is available out in the world. So you may ask, what is their Islamic conception of this reality? We say, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, in the clearest sense. So Adam received some words from Allah. Allah taught him how to turn in repentance. So he did repent to Allah, and Allah pardoned him and He forgave him, and verily Allah is the one who often forgives His creation, and He's the most merciful. So this concept of repentance is very relevant in my life and your life, because it is the only way we can eliminate sins. And what do you know about sins? If you were here in the last lecture, we said that among the factors of the decrease in our iman running on empty is disobedience and sins. Actually, Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ Sin is so dangerous that Allah says there isn't a single calamity that befalls upon you except it is the result of what you have earned with your own hands. Every single sin that we have in our lives, whether you get sick, whether you lose some money, whether you lose your job, anything. مَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ It is due to what you have earned with your own hands. This is the consequences of sins. Allah says, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِي النَّاسِ لِيُذِيقَهُمْ بَعْضَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجَعُونَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ Allah says, corruption has appeared on the land and in the sea. Do what men have earned with their hands. For Allah to make him taste the consequence of their actions, perhaps they will return. Perhaps they will return. And on these premises, we will be having this particular talk tonight. How do we return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How do we return? Because are we not facing this corruption on earth and in the sea? Are we not living it today? All over the universe. So much so that it's coming over here. Usually this place used to be considered more safe. It is more safe than other places. But the corruption started to creep in. And that requires some actions on my behalf and on your behalf. We must do something before the corruption overtakes us. And then we will be destroyed as the nations that came before us were destroyed. Repentance then is something that was encouraged and commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in so many verses in the Quran that I cannot even enumerate all of them, but I will quote to you a couple that are relevant to our discussion. The first one is, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا Oh, you who believe, turn to Allah in sincere repentance. Here we were commanded. Allah is commanding us Now, does Allah need us to repent? Brothers and sisters, is Allah in need of my repentance and yours? Is it going to increase the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?